Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. Well, we're talking about the sixth trait of a true believer. We said, Rasulullah ﷺ said, Al-Muslimu man salim al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadihi. He is not a Muslim from whose tongue and hand his or her neighbor is not safe. I talked about the impact of the language that we use. Let's talk about the impact of our hands. Brothers and sisters, hand is a very powerful tool. Allah has given two of them to all of us. These two hands, we can use them for productive work or destructive work. Productive work is when we become beneficial to our neighbors, to our fellow human being. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he and the true believer is the one who is actually beneficial to other human beings. You know, if we can be beneficial, then we are true believers. Beneficial is only possible if we use our hands in the right way. So how can you use your hand in the right way? Knocking on the doors of your neighbor and offering your neighbor some help. Would they need help in shopping? Imagine they're elderly, they haven't got anybody to go and shop for them. Maybe your neighbor needs some fence fixing. Maybe their wall needs a bit of painting. Maybe their house needs a bit of cleaning. Offering our hands to our neighbors in a productive manner is the essence of our faith and the true nature of a true believer. Our Prophet ﷺ said, Iman is divided into 71 categories. The top one is to say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. We all know that. And the 71st one, or the 70th one, is to pick up thorns from the streets, obstacles from the streets. In other words, with our hand, cleaning the streets so that people would be safe. If we see something lying on the floor, pick it up and put it in the dustbin. So we don't litter ourselves with our hand, and we don't leave litter lying around. The other day I was driving and I saw a van passing by, in front of me actually, and from the van window, somebody threw a bottle straight out onto the pavement. I was quite horrified by this behavior. So I beeped my horn and they ignored me. I beeped again, so they pulled up on the side. I think they wanted a confrontation. I lowered my window and I realized the drivers were one guy Muslim and the passenger was a Muslim. So there were two Muslim brothers in their van. So I said salam to them and I said, this is not the true trait of a Muslim, that they litter the street and keep the streets and make it harmful. They're apologetic. They were very, 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 very embarrassed. You know what they did? They came out of their van, they went and picked up the bottle and they threw the bottle in the bin. Well, that's my way of doing things. I don't think you should do the same. Maybe it's not safe. But the bottom line is, don't harm others with your hand. Don't allow your streets to be unclean or remain unclean while your hands are strong and able. Offer your hand in productive work to your neighbors and your friends and families. Let them see the goodness that you can bring on this earth to humanity with the good work of your hand. There are people who use their hand in destructive manner. Fights on the streets, hitting other people, being physically abusive. They use their hand to do evil things, commit crime, commit theft, harm, robbery. All of these accounts on the Day of Judgment will become very visible. There is a verse of the Quran where Allah says, on this day, اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. He says in the Quran in Surah Yasin, on that day we'll seal your mouth and we'll allow your hands to talk and legs to testify, because you will attempt to lie. My brothers and sisters, the hand that you and I have used would speak against you and me if we have used our hands in unproductive work or ill productive work. Destructive work. These hands that we cherish so much will speak against us. The legs that we have on which we walk will testify against our actions if we have been unfaithful and untrue to the true traits of believers. So if you are a believer, if you believe in Allah on the last day, you will use your hand for productive work. Never for destructive work. Using your hand for productive work includes writing. Write your thoughts for the benefit of humanity. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ, our Prophet ﷺ said. The best of human being is the one who is most beneficial to humanity. Write with your hand. Let people benefit from your hand. In other words, you're writing your thoughts. Your knowledge, let it be spread by writing. There is a fight that everyone wants to wage. The best fight is the fight using the pen. Articulation, your thoughts and your intellect, all used using a pen, is more powerful than any weapons that you can think of. Our pen, our hand, should be the tool for change. Changing the world for a better world using our hand, by sharing our thoughts. Use your hand to express love to your children, to your family. Give them a hug. Hold them in warmth, in love and affection. Use your hand to show and demonstrate love and care. Use your hand to gather people around for good work. وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, Allah says in the Quran. And don't cooperate together in that which is evil and bad. Only cooperate with one another for good work. And you can cooperate using your hand, bringing people together. Whenever we do a gesture of people coming together, this is what we do, using our hand. These hands are very powerful. Ask somebody who doesn't have hand, or who has hand but has limited ability or restricted abilities to be able to use their hand. Ask somebody who has had two hands, but one of them or both of them has become dysfunctional at some stage of their life. Ask somebody. If you have experienced that, you would know the value of our hand, our hands. So anyone who harms their neighbor, our Prophet ﷺ said, is not a true believer, with their hand or with their tongue. Question is, when was the last time you hit somebody with your hand? When was the last time you expressed your love to somebody with your hand? When was the last time you used your hand for good thing? And when was the last time you used your hand for bad thing? This is the question that we should all be reflecting on, my brothers and sisters. Our hand, the way we use it on the Day of Judgment, will be either beneficial for us or harmful for us. So this hadith that I've talked about, it's very simple but very profound. The hadith is, are our neighbors safe from our tongue and from our hands? This question is not just imperative, but essential for our existence in our country, with our neighbors and our society. You know, when our Prophet ﷺ used to walk the streets, they used to call him Al-Amin and Al-Sadiq, the trustworthy and the truthful. When you and I, Muslims, unfortunately nowadays, walk the streets of our country, non-Muslims call us the terrorists. Is because we have used our tongue and our hand, at least some of our brothers and sisters have done, in a very, very destructive and negative way. They've maligned Islam, they've destroyed the image of Islam, they've held Islam hostage, and they have desecrated the wonderful religion of Allah. Our hand and our tongue, we must guard. I hear some people, even when they say, brother, I'm right and you're wrong, I'm preaching the words of Allah. Well, if you're going to preach the words of Allah, why be abusive? If you are going to quote the verses of the Quran, why quote them in anger and rage? When you're quoting our Prophet ﷺ's statement, why quote them when you are thinking you are right and everyone else is wrong, in that arrogant state? Those are abuse of tongue. Those are examples of abuse of our hands. No neighborhood would ever be safe if we are behaving this way. No people will ever love us and trust us if our actions and our words and our hands are terrible. People love people who are beautiful. Not just appearance and looks and their clothes, not their glamour, but their inner beauty that lies in their heart. And believe you me, inner beauty manifests itself through our tongue and our hands, in our action. And finally, Rasulullah ﷺ said, "Ad-dinu al-mu'amala." Religion is all about social interaction. You can't do social interaction without your hand and without your tongue. So, to finish off, can you start thinking about adopting this sixth trait to become the true believer? A believer who creates and is committed to safe neighborhood by being good with his tongue and with his hands, with her tongue and with her hand, to create safer, stable, peaceful neighborhood. I hope and I pray Allah gives me and you the ability to practice this trait, trait number six, creating safer neighborhood. Until next time, take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.